Welcome back, you guys, to another GFIT video. Today, we had a special guest, Alyssa Gonzalez. She's also known as Princess Number One. She's my daughter, she's 9 years old, and she's my training partner today. We began the workout today with a nice dynamic warm-up. We focused on her shoulder mobility, focused on stretching, focused on getting blood flow throughout our body. We started off with basic stretches. I got myself a new little toy, it's a little rubber band. You can get them at most stores. The reason I got it, I evolved from the PVC pipe is because it helps with more mobility and helps put your positioning in different areas. And I got to have my daughter help me today in offering resistance and giving me a little more deeper stretch. We did it back and forth to each other. We got warmed up. We did a couple jogs. We did a couple ab rollouts utilizing the ab wheel. We started with 5 ab rollouts to 5 push-ups. 6 ab rollouts to 6 push-ups, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9, 9, 10, 10. After that, you should be really stretched out, really warmed up, a lot of blood flow to it, and ready to go. We started the first workout off with standing shoulder press with the barbell. Notice my daughter's bar. It's not a typical 45-pound bar or a 35-pound bar. It's actually a practice bar. You know, she's only 9 years old. Doesn't mean she shouldn't work out. Of course she should work out. But we also have to accommodate towards her age and towards her strength level. So she's using the practice bar. We did 10 reps of shoulder press with the barbell, and then we superset it with step ups. We started off with body weight, and then we moved up and adding weight to each side. You can do it with plates, you can do it with dumbbells, or you can do it just with one plate. The second exercise we did, I like to call it the Woodchoppers. I like to get an athletic stance. The athletic stance is great because it helps utilize your core, utilize your legs, and your body as one. So always remember, stomach tight, be firm, athletic stance, defensive stance. Use the stance in absolutely every physical activity you mostly do. So stand completely straight up in athletic stance, put your pressure on your heels, stay tight, be firm, back straight, chin up. Engage your lumbar, like I always say in all my videos, lumbar, lumbar, lumbar. Place your hands in a fingertip lock action, okay? A lot of people come here, and it was great to do this too, but your right hand will overpower on the other side. I always like to go here and be firm, be completely locked. Chest out, chin up, like I said, engage your lumbar. We supersetted this with pull-ups. The reason why we did pull-ups is because we wanna be strong, you know? We don't wanna just be strong with weights, we wanna be strong with body weights as well. Pull-ups is one of the most effective body weight movements you can do. So I helped my daughter out with a couple of pull-up action. You know, she's not too strong yet, but she's going to get stronger, and I know that. She gets upset because she can't do pull-ups. I tell her she needs to do more of this, but she needs to do more pull-ups and she's going to get stronger. She gets a little upset, but I let her know that the more she does it, the more she's going to evolve from it. The next exercise we did was tricep pull-downs on the cables with the rope. We did a little quick little, I like to call it a little hit circuit with weights. We did tricep pull-downs, we did 10, and then we did 10 push-ups immediately after. My little nephew came walking by, so I made him jump in with us because it's good. Say if you have a partner, if you're by yourself, you can just work. You do 10 pull-downs, then you do 10 push-ups, and you repeat that for 4 rounds. You move up in weight each time. On the last set, my 4th round, I did a drop set. I had my partner lower the weight immediately after I was done. Our fourth workout we did a little circuit. We started off with incline dumbbell press, close grip, smashing the dumbbells together. It's good to smash them together and press your chest together. And utilize, bring it all the way down and completely all the way forward, sticking your chest out, keeping your back rounded in the lumbar. And we supersetted this to a dip to a push-up on dumbbells. If you watched any of my other videos, you know that we did this workout already with on a chest day and tricep day. So utilizing this one with body weight is very essential because I don't want my daughter to do incline press. So I had her do the dumbbells to the dip to the push-up. A third session with a dip in a dip position to a leg raise. So that was 3 circuits. I did 10 incline dumbbell press, I did dip to push-up position, 10 reps, and then 10 dip to leg raises. I believe one of the most effective core workouts to help with body weight strength is a crow. I had my daughter doing the dumbbell. She's gotten really strong. She was never able to hold this position, but with practice and continuous effort, she could able to hold the crow position now. Very difficult movement. So notice how I was helping her, guiding her, and right when I felt she had it locked in, I released my hands a little bit. It's good to do this with a partner. The way I do the crow position, I always utilize my knees to put pressure on my hands. It helps build a nice platform and stabilizes you a little bit more. You know, I've been doing this for years. Like I said, the crow position is very effective, very essential to do. And if you really want to gain body weight strength, get the crow down. Once you learn the crow, you're able to adjust, and you're able to feel your body weight and feel your strength. You feel your strength, and you feel yourself getting a lot stronger. And then obviously I did a handstand to a crow, you know. It's a little more advanced movement. Don't look at it and be like, oh my goodness, I'm not gonna be able to do it, because believe me, you could, it just takes time.
Thank you for watching my Daddy's G-Fit video. Please make sure to subscribe.